Hello once again, this is James and welcome to my Microsoft Word videos. Today we're going to look at formatting text in Microsoft Word. Formatting in word processing means changing the appearance of text, like for example changing the size, the color, the letter styling, among others. The prerequisite to formatting, or the basic requirement to formatting, is to first highlight or select the text you need to format. Let us see how we do highlighting or selecting in Word. Let us dive straight into our Word document and we see. We have this sample document here, displaying text, not formatted. Let us try to see how we can highlight. As we said, highlight notifies Word or notifies the system that this is the area you want to effect with the formatting option. So the basic formatting tips are these. First, you can do what we call the drag, click and drag method of highlighting. I would click where I want to start my highlight, press and hold down the left mouse button, then move the mouse. Moving it backwards deselects and moving it forward or to the right selects, and moving it to the left backwards deselects. So you only release when you've reached where you want to stop your format. So that is one method of highlighting. If for example I wanted to highlight one word like online, I'll double click in it. That can also select it. If I wanted to highlight this whole sentence, I would point outside it. Notice that the pointer becomes a white shaped arrow, not close. When you point near the work, it becomes an I-beam, but it should be a white arrow shaped pointer. So this time you only need to click once and it will highlight that whole line of text. Just point in line with that text, then click once, then it will highlight all the work. I can also use what we call the shift and click technique. If I can borrow this online keyboard, notice that when I hold shift, the shift keys will light up. So I'll click where I want to start my selection, hold shift, then come and click where I want to end my selection. The beauty of this is can also add on to the selection. If you keep holding shift, you can click somewhere else to add on to the selection, or you can reduce the selection by clicking backwards to reduce the selection or increase it. All of this you do while holding the shift key. So that is also another method of selecting work. If you want to select all the text on your work, we can come to editing here, we click and we say select, then we say select all. So this one will highlight all the work which is on this document. Or alternatively, you can press the control key, if I could bring back our keyboard, control key, then you press A. This will also highlight all the work regardless of how many pages you have on your document. So those are the basic tricks in highlighting work. Maybe one more last trick. If I point at the beginning of my work or anywhere outside the margins of the work, when I double click, it highlights a paragraph. When I triple click, that one will highlight all the contents of my document, regardless of how many pages I have. I said you triple click 3 times and very fast, and there you have it. All your work will be highlighted. Now let us do some basic formatting on the title. For example, I can highlight it. We could start with changing the size. I could drop down the list and pick from a list of values. Notice how my title is growing according to the size. Supposing I wanted it to be size 29, So when you look at the list, there is no 29. So what I will do, I'll click up here, rub away this, then I type my 29 and press enter. So that is how you do it. Supposing I wanted size 25 is not on the list, so I'll just click up there, rub this, type 25 and enter. So basically that is how you change the size of your font on the keyboard, I mean the size of your text. Alternatively, if you are to use the keyboard to do that, you press the control key, then you keep pressing this button which has the square bracket. The square bracket or the closing square bracket increases the size of the text. Hope you notice how the font is changing here. And the square bracket to the left or the opening square bracket decreases the size of the text. That is another trick you can use to increase or decrease the size of your work in case you don't use this menu up here. So basically that is what happens there. Then we can alternatively also change the fonts. Notice how the font has changed. I hope you see how fonts keep on changing. So somewhere around here is where I change your font size. Then below we have these options. This one, when you point at it, it says bold, or you can press Ctrl B to make the text bold. When I click in it, this font is a bit bold, so you may not see it clearly. Let's use this. I think now it becomes much clearer. You notice the difference. The beauty of it all is the way you activate these commands here is the same way you deactivate them. When you click once, it becomes active. Look at that yellow square which comes around it. Means that button is locked in, so that option is active. Click again, and the yellow square goes away. It means you've deactivated that option. You have the I, which is for bolding, I mean for making the text italics. I hope you notice what happens. Then the U for underlining. You also have underline options when you choose the drop down list. You can even choose an underline color. Not very clear color. So basically that is what goes on there. Hope you notice. You have this option here called strike through. It can cross out the work. We have an option called superscript and subscript. These two options, powers and bases, use the mathematical concept. If I say 112, then I highlight by 2 here, then I come and choose subscript. Notice what happens. The 2 goes down as a base. If the same 2 were to use the superscript, it will make it a power. So basically that is what those do. We are still just looking at the formatting options available. We also didn't look at these fellas here. These ones also help to increase the size of the work. Okay. They decrease or increase according to this menu here. So you see 26, 28 as it is listed down here. Then we have this option here. These are text effects which may not be in some windows, I mean in some office below 2010. It's a cool effect. I think you can see it. I can have text highlight color. Can have something like that. or I can even change the text itself. What can we use? So that would be fitting. Let's put that yellow there. So you make something like that, but as you notice, I first do the highlight. So all of these you've seen how we can do some basic formatting in Word. So this font option here, where you can do a little formatting here and there, has this option up here which says clear formatting. So this one resets the work back to its original form, so all the formatting goes away apart from the text highlight, which is not considered a formatting option. So that will take back the work to its original form. Now lastly, there is this option arrow here. When you click on it, it will bring the extended menu for other additional formatting options. So that is what we shall look at in our next video regarding formatting. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video.